Hello and welcome to the session. Let's discuss the following question. It says, solve the following system of inequalities graphically. So let's move on to the solution. The first inequality given to us is x plus y less than equal to 9, and its corresponding equation of line is x plus y is equal to 9. And to draw this line, we need to have two points. So if y is 0, then x is equal to 9, and if x is 0, then y is equal to 9. So we need to plot the points 9, 0 and 0, 9 to draw the line x plus y is equal to 9. Let's now draw the line x plus y is equal to 9. Now, when x is 0, y is 9, so it is this point, and when y is 0, x is 9, so it is this point. Now we join these two points to get the required line. Now we have to shade the region representing the inequality x plus y less than equal to 9. For that, we take any point not lying on the line x plus y is equal to 9, and we'll check whether that point satisfies this inequality or not. If that point satisfies this inequality, we'll shade the region which contains that point, and if that point doesn't satisfy this inequality, we'll shade the region which doesn't contain that point, and we take that point as 0, 0. So if x is 0 and y is 0, then the inequality becomes 0 plus 0 is less than equal to 9, which is true. That is, 0 is less than equal to 9 is true. That means the point 0, 0 satisfies the inequality x plus y less than 9. So for the inequality x plus y less than equal to 9, we'll shade the region which contains the point 0, 0. Now this is the line x plus y is equal to 9. Now we shade the region which contains the point 0, 0 for the inequality x plus y less than equal to 9. So this is the region which contains the point 0, 0. Here is 0. So let's now shade this region. Now since the inequality contains the sign less than equal to, we darken this line, which shows that this line is included in the solution region. Now the second inequality given to us is y greater than x, and the corresponding equation of line is y is equal to x. So if x is 0, then y is 0. If x is 1, then y is 1. So let's now draw the line y is equal to x. Y is equal to x is the line passing through the origin, and where y is equal to x, so it is this line. If x is 1, then y is 1. If x is 0, then y is 0, so it is this line. Now we have to identify the region for the inequality y greater than x. For that, we take any point not lying on the line y is equal to x. This is the line y is equal to x, and we have to take any point not lying on this line. Now we see that the point 1, 2 does not lie on the line y is equal to x. So we take the point as 1, 2, and we'll check if this point satisfies this inequality. We'll shade the region which contains this point. Now if x is 1, y is 2, then the inequality is 2 greater than 1. greater than 1, which is true. That means the point 1, 2 satisfies the inequality y greater than x. So we'll shade the region for the inequality y greater than x, which contains the point 1, 2. We have to shade the region for the inequality y greater than x, which contains the point 1, 2. This is the point 1, 2. And we have to shade the region which contains this point. So this is the region which contains this point. So we'll shade this region. So we have shaded the region for the inequality y greater than x, and in this the line y is equal to x is not included because the inequality does not contain the sign of equality. Now the third inequality given to us is x greater than equal to 0, and corresponding equation of line is x is equal to 0. Now we know that the y-axis is the line x is equal to 0. So this is the line, y-axis is the line x is equal to 0. Now we know that to the right side of y-axis, all the x are greater than 0, and to the left side of y-axis, all the x are less than 0. So we shade the region to the right side of y-axis because we have to shade the region for the inequality x greater than equal to 0. So it would be this region. Now since the inequality contains the sign greater than equal to, we need to darken the line x is equal to 0, which shows that the line x is equal to 0 is included in the solution region. Now the region in black is common to all the three regions, and it is the required solution region for the system of inequalities 1, 2 and 3. So this completes the question. Bye for now. Take care. Have a good day.